Hi dear students, now today in today's era, whenever we are preparing for any competitive exam, the key in the exam is that you know what you know, how much you know, and how much you are actually able to recall in the exam. So whenever we are studying in two methods. One is an active recall method, one is a passive recall method. So when we talk about passive reading is you know which actually constitutes the bulk of your preparation, where you are reading your notes that you took in the class multiple times. But in addition to them, you also need to practice active recall, and that means you need to put your mind at an unknown problem and then mark the answer and see how you are able to think and apply what you know in the question. So that means these two things have to go parallel in your preparation. You have to study, you have to understand the concepts, you have to make notes, which is very, very important, probably the most important part of your preparation. But you also need to know how to apply what you know in an MCQ. And that is where your DQB or the DAMS question bank resource on your eMedicos app comes into play. Now, today in this video, I'll tell you how to utilize the DQB and what all is present in DQB for your, utility. And I also want you to know that DQB is a unique resource which is placed very, very uniquely in the eMedicos app. eMedicos app is a single stop solution for a medical aspirant, where we have for our medical PG aspirant, where we have put everything in one place. You don't need to have hundreds of apps to play around. Your test series is in the eMedicos, your DQB is in the eMedicos. And your DAMS video library is in the eMedicos, your DAMS live lectures are happening in the eMedicos. So you know where you have to go for your question bank. So how will it feel like when you go to the app? When you go to the app, I want you to look at in the bottom part of the app, you will see a launch button saying the question mark there saying Q bank. When you click on it, a question bank like what you see in front of you will appear. This question bank would have on the top two features. One is called as the flashcards or the DAMS decks, and other is the custom module, which I'll explain in due course. And then you will have subject-wise question modules. And these modules are questions which have been handpicked by the faculty members, and they are known to have a very good strike rate in the real exam. So you can see for yourself, we have questions on pharmacology, microbiology, pathology, like subject-wise, and when you click on them, they will become topic-wise. So you can actually go ahead and do your questions topic wise and practice. And this is what you're supposed to utilize along with your classes. So whenever your classes are going on, you're supposed to utilize these before the class or after the class, whichever your module is. So a lot of students have asked me to, who are the students who are eligible for DQB access in the app? If you are a DAMS regular course student, foundation course student, test and discussion student, okay, both face to face and test satellite, you are eligible for this DQB. All others can subscribe to DQB extra. So it is open to subscription, but people who are regular foundation and test and discussion have this module with them in their own offering, and it is in their package itself. But the specialty of DAMS question bank is that we do not stop at the subject-wise distribution of questions. You have multiple columns where a lot of new pattern questions, which are actually the game changers in today's in the AIIMS and the NEET PG exams, which are available for you. On the top, you will see that we have created questions on clinical vignettes. We have added a lot of clinical vignettes, and we are continuously adding more and more in it. What is the reason for doing so? NEET PG 2020 was full of clinical vignettes, and this is where this is your go-to resource towards the end of your preparation. Let me explain to you. I want you to be finishing your subject-wise modules with the classes, and towards the end, when you are now looking back to connect the dots, now you go towards clinical vignettes towards the end, and that will be your October month where you will be practicing more clinical vignettes. But look at below them. You will see a separate section called as image-based question bank. The images form, out of 200 questions in the AIIMS exam, 60-70 questions are visuals. Out of 300 questions in the NEET PG exam, 50-60 are visuals. So visual questions are a very important part of the game, and we have included a separate question bank for image-based questions. Not only that, if you look at it, there is a separate section for extended matching questions. These are unique theme-based questions with choices which can be more than four. You may have seven choices, eight choices. It's a theme-based question. And every year in AIIMS exam, you have five, six at least questions on this pattern. And this is your go-to resource if you are an AIIMS aspirant. In AIIMS, there are 5 to 10 questions on video-based questions also. And you can see there is a special cue bank for video-based question practice there. And I believe that that makes DQB a very unique resource. You have video-based questions, 2D images, as well as movement images with you. So GIF images here, so that you are well-versed with the way in which the real exam would feel like. In AIIMS, there are 10 questions on match the following, and you have a match the following here. And there is a special pattern in which you have 10 questions in the AIIMS exam. And many people, they don't prepare for it. That is called as multiple completion type. And we have a separate cue bank for match the following and the multiple completion type questions also. How would this cue bank feel like? So when you will go into the extended matching questions, you will find the question will have a theme. For example, I'm showing you a question here. The theme is diagnosis of red eye. And you have a question. And there will be multiple questions on this theme. When I swipe, you will see multiple questions on this theme. And the answers would be all causes of painful red eye, like glaucoma, iritis, conjunctivitis. And this is the pattern in the AIIMS exam. In AIIMS exam, you have questions on extended matching type. That means there's a theme and there are multiple questions on that theme with all the DDs given in choices, so that you have actually, in effect, you are dealing with 7 or 8 choices like you see in this question. Image-based questions, what we have done is we have arranged the image-based questions subject-wise. So this is how the subject-wise image-based QBank would feel like. And when I open it, you know, this is how it would look like. I already talked about that image-based questions are a very, very important part of both AIIMS and NEET PG exam, probably the most crucial part of the AIIMS exam. Can you imagine now, out of 200 in AIIMS, you have 60-70 questions only on visuals, and you know this is important. So this is how a visual question would look like. This is a radiology visual question in the visual question bank, image-based question bank, where you see the pseudomembranous enterocolitis showing that accordion sign. And this sign has been asked in a previous NEET PG exam as well. And now in the new version of the app, we have even added video-based questions. In this video-based questions, and why we have added is obvious, because AIIMS has taken a leap ahead of all other exams, and they have 5 to 10 video questions in the exam. And this is where, you know, you have a patient where some tremor will be shown to you in this video, and all the causes are there, and you need to find out what is the cause of tremor in this patient. Similar questions on test being performed and have been added in your video-based question bank. And I also want to tell you, the key here is that these are all hand-picked by faculty members. These are all faculty members have selected these questions. And second thing is, this bank is very dynamic. We keep adding. So I believe by the end of next month or so, we would have added maybe 2000 more clinical vignettes in the paper. We are, actually working on it constantly, especially about the new patterns. We are always adding new and new things which we feel are more important in new pattern. So the dynamic nature of the bank makes it very interesting. This is how the clinical vignette would look like. You have a long stem question and choices and a clinical story to look at. And I want you to know, this was the pattern in the NEET PG 2020 exam. This is the proposed pattern of next exam also. Clinical vignettes, so applied aspects. So you can see this is a microbiology question, but it has been asked in a clinical vignette manner. You can see there is a 10 member family, out of which 8 has 4-day history of after a party, diarrhea, abdominal cramps. And you can see the lab values, and you have Seagull appearance given. So, this is applied microbiology, which has been now given due regard even in the next exam. Look at another example of a clinical vignette. Now, this is an obese or diabetic man with a history of, some examination finding given, some microscopic finding given with oval budding structure. So it's all integrated clinical vignettes. So this is what we excel at. And I think if somebody starts subject-wise and then ends at the clinical vignette, his preparation is going in a very good direction, because he's collecting the dots and connecting them towards the end. That is the entire beauty of the bank. Now in the DAMS Q bank, it also comes with DAMS decks. I made a separate video about dams decks where you have flashcards which you can yourself determine in a spaced repetition like manner, and you can revise all the important factual topics through the dams decks. And we have actually taken all the most volatile subjects and we've already included them in the dams decks for you. Not only that, you have a custom module here where you can select the difficulty level, you can select the kind of questions that you want to use to make a test, and you can select the number of questions, and you can re-revise your question bank again and again by maybe making a test on what questions you got wrong, what questions you could not attempt, what questions you bookmarked, so that towards the end you are actually retesting yourself, you're retesting your recall, and you're making yourself more and more strong. So I believe that the cycle here is class, notes, form your content. DQB, test series, class test, SWT, GT form your exam skill. If somebody can do them together, you keep doing them together, the class, question bank, later on test, you keep doing it, and then towards the end, we go towards revision. So these are the three components of your dream success in any exam: content, exam skill, revision. So you begin with the content, then you go on to the exam skill, and these, we have included all important skills that you need to develop in this particular QBank. And I'm very, very happy to, be able to tell you about how to use this question bank here. And this question bank, you can directly subscribe by going on eMedicos app and clicking on subscribe on the app in the courses section. I wish you all happy learning, and I wish you all the best for your exams.